What's up, YouTube? So before we get started with this video, on First Take, they're going to be talking about the New England Patriots, Patrick Chung, and how he was just caught a drug charge. So let's see what they have to say about that.
Does this tarnish the Patriots' image?
I think it tarnishes their image. It doesn't matter at the end of the day, because when you win the Super Bowls, you win the Super Bowls. But we have to think about things. You've got Spygate. You've got Deflategate. You've got Aaron Hernandez, and we know how unfortunate that situation was. We've got this. We've got Robert Kraft, you know, who I've got a great relationship with and revere the man, but he had himself in a quandary. You've got Bill Belichick, courtesy of Spygate, being fined $500,000. You had that whole thing in the 2014-2015 season, if I remember correctly, some trickery on the part of the players about whether or not a player was eligible or ineligible to receive the ball in a given play, where you had some coaches thinking that it was cheating and what have you. I mean, the list goes on and on. So when you look at it from that perspective, in the end, it's not going to matter when they win the Super Bowls due to the greatness of Tom Brady and Bill Belichick.
Exactly. It's going to be the on-the-field play that people care about. So I don't think this is going to necessarily ruin the image of the New England Patriots, because I tell you what, so maybe Deflategate or maybe Spygate, because that's something on the field that's you can consider that cheating or something that can be trolled in the football world. But whatever these guys do away from the football field and at their home, the Patriots don't have any control of that. If this guy gets caught with cocaine in this house and gets arrested, the Patriots don't have any control of that. That's him. That's on him. Does it look good for the organization? Probably not. But again, he's his own man. These are grown adults. If he decides to make those type of choices, then that's on him. Now, if he was slinging dope outside the New England Patriots locker room, now that's a different story. That's definitely a different story. But no, whatever he does at home and behind closed doors, that's on him. He gets arrested. Hey, that's on him. It's not good, but hey, that has nothing to do with the New England Patriots. So let's continue.
As these things pile on, it almost gives you the impression, and I'm not saying that's the case, because we know that with Robert Kraft, domestic violence is one thing he's not told. You do that, you're going to be off his team. But it's like, it's almost as if there's a lot of other things that they're not paying attention to because they're focused on winning football.
The scandals for the Patriots absolutely tarnished their legacy. The issue is, though, that they've accomplished so much more than anyone else that even by tarnishing their legacy, it still has them as the greatest dynasty in the history of the NFL by so much it's embarrassing. Mm-hmm. So even with the tarnishing, it can't knock them down. This doesn't do anything at all. You have 52 guys on the roster. You have a practice squad. You have a coaching staff. You have roughly, let's say it's in the ballpark of 100 people involved in a football team. Take 100 people, any random sampling of 100 people, anywhere in American life. Is someone using cocaine recreationally? Yes. By the way, I don't take that lightly. Like when I hear about cannabis use, it's like, oh, stop. But it's all the studies that alcohol, cannabis, if anything's worse, it's alcohol. That's every objective study peer-reviewed ever done on the subject. The reason one is prohibited continually since prohibition and the other was no longer prohibited is all BS cultural nonsense and a racist drug czar named Harry Anslinger. But that's not cocaine. Cocaine is much more serious and should be taken seriously. Nevertheless, we can't ignore the fact that more than 1 in 100 people in the United States use it recreationally. So if you scour a football team, you will find some of them. And I don't think that in and of itself tarnishes the Patriots really at all.
Cumulative stuff.
Yeah, I definitely agree with Max on this one. Definitely, if you take a group of 100 people, you're probably going to find someone using coke or doing a bunch of other little different things. But I would like to throw in there, most of these 100 guys that he's talking about, they're millionaires. So that's going to have more opportunities for them to do a lot more different things than a normal group of 100 people. But anyways, though, so like I said, I agree with what Max is saying. But as far as Patrick Chung affecting the team, that doesn't affect the team at all. Like I said before, in 20 years, nobody's going to care about, oh, well, look at, you know, the New England Patriots, they won 6 Super Bowls and they went 9 times and all this other type of stuff. Oh, but look, hold on. Patrick Chung, remember he was arrested for cocaine? Remember that? Do you remember that? No one's going to say that. All anybody's ever going to care about in 20 or 30 years is that the New England Patriots have won 6 Super Bowl rings, and the small details like Patrick Chung getting caught with cocaine or whatever little incidences have happened during the course of winning Super Bowls, nobody's going to care about. All they're going to care about is how many rings they have, and that'll be it. So let's continue.
Matters. When stuff piles on one thing after another, it matters. If they're isolated incidents and circumstances, that would be different. But when you have a team, a franchise that has so many different kind of unconscionable things associated with it in the eyes of its contemporaries, then that's the kind of thing that could ultimately affect you. Because in the end, what we're going to do is, what do we always do? We reach out to those connected to the sport, those in the know, to sort of frame things historically. We don't just rely on ourselves. We rely on their level of expertise because they're actual participants. So don't think about just the Patriots. Think about what the other 31 teams will say about them
about the other
when
30.
It's all
yeah,
over.
But let's,
and that's what I'm saying.
Do you think there's even one other team with someone on that team or coaching staff that are not using cocaine recreationally?
I do believe almost every team can make an argument that they haven't had all of those different things associated with them than the Patriots have.
Well, yeah, that's true. Every team has its problems more than others, some more than others. But again, like I said, what these guys do on their own time, that's not the responsibility of the team. Does it look good? No, but these are grown men. These are grown. Whatever you do at home by yourself, that's on you. Like I said, it'd be a different thing if Patrick Chung was slanging dope out of the New England Patriots locker room and he was straight hustling out there slanging rocks outside of the New England Patriots parking lot. Okay, that's a different story. But when he got caught at home or wherever he was at, away from the compound and away from football. So that's not a reflection really of the team. That's not a reflection of the team. And the same applies for any other teams. All teams have their issues. And all teams, we don't necessarily hear everything that happens in these teams because they keep it covered. It's only the biggest of things that get out that people hear because it's newsworthy. But like I said, Patrick Chung, he's his own man. It's not a reflection on the New England Patriots. In 20 years, nobody's going to care. All anybody's going to care about is that they have 6 rings up until this point, and that's fine. Nobody's going to care about, ooh, remember Patrick Chung, how we got arrested? Oh, yeah, no one's going to care about that. So let's continue.
They're one franchise. Now they're winning. And, you know, again, I think Mr. Kraft is a phenomenal owner. You know, I got a lot of love for him. And I think Bill Belichick is the best. And I think that Tom Brady is the greatest of this generation at what he does. But the bottom line is you can't ignore the fact that all of these things come associated with one franchise, particularly in a day and age where everything we look at, the way we microscopically judge these athletes in the modern day era, to have all of this stuff associated with one franchise, it's just not a good thing.
Let me ask you a question. Do you think the scandals involved, I mean the cheating scandals basically, not like recreational drug use of illicit drugs, even if they're serious like cocaine, but do you think the scandals associated with the Patriots have more to do, because it may be some of both, more to do with a culture that starts with Belichick, do anything it takes to win, or more to do with the media scrutiny of a team that is in the Super Bowl 50% of the time over a 2-decade span?
I would say both.
But which one more?
It's hard for me to say.
To me, I suspect.
It's hard for me to say because, again, you know, as great as it is in terms of the results, one could argue that playing for Bill Belichick makes you want to find alternative methods of distraction because he's so fixated on that.
Nah, I wouldn't say that. Bill Belichick is very militant, but not to the point where I think players are going to be out there start using cocaine because Bill Belichick is so bad. I mean, it would manifest itself in different ways, and you would have heard other things from different players, and they probably wouldn't be winning if Bill Belichick wasn't the way he is. So, I don't know. Let's continue.
And he has you so fixated that you might feel like you're not a part of the planet Earth for 6 months, for crying out loud, because of what he's subjecting you to in an effort to win. Everybody don't have Giselle to go home to. If you look deep inside yourself, some people, if you know that you won by alternative means, if you knew that you didn't win legitimately, sitting at home in the privacy of just yourself and having to live with that is a lot.
What
to
if you
take
assume that the other guy's also doing the same
thing?
Well,
then that's a different challenge.
Okay.
Wait a minute.
This is the argument during the steroid era.
That's exactly what I was going to bring up. Certainly, you can make that argument. But what I'm saying is, when you know, it's just like we watched the movie several times. I've watched Will Smith and Ali with Jamie Foxx and all of these movies. It's a great film. And I love the scene where Will Smith is in a car in Philadelphia with James Toney, who's playing Joe Frazier. Yeah. And James Toney's like, all I got is this. I don't need you. And he's like, yeah, but you know you ain't the champ. You'll know you ain't the real champ. That matters. That matters to a lot of people.
So that does matter, but that's the type of stuff that'll get to you like you said, late at night when you're by yourself and it's just you and your thoughts, deep down inside, you know you cheated. You know you cheated the system. You know you cheated everybody. And you know you didn't really win. And you always ask yourself, could I beat whoever I beat without that steroids? And that you'll never get that monkey off your back. And that will always haunt you to the day you die. Just like some of these basketball players and football players that never earn a Super Bowl ring. They've earned a ton of money, but they didn't do the main objective of playing a sport, which is to win a championship. That's where Carmelo Anthony is struggling right now to find a team to play with and try to get his ring, because he chose the money over the ring earlier in his career, and now he's starting to feel it. All his friends have rings except for him, and that's an elite club that you can never get into if you never won a ring. You could be a Hall of Famer, but if you never won a ring, that's a certain club that you cannot get into if you're ringless. And that will eat at you to the day you die. So let's continue.
People who believe they're great, to people who are true champions, it matters for the most part how you acquire that greatness or how you validate that greatness. When you know in the privacy of your soul that you've invalidated it by cutting corners and circumventing rules and regulations in order to pull it off, that's something that messes with you. The money might compromise it to some degree, because some people might not give a damn because they're going for the money. But there are a lot of champions. No, that matters to them.
That's why these things are not black and white, so to speak. And they are. Once you go on that slippery slope, I'm not breaking the rule. I'm bending the rule. Eventually, you may have to come to that moment of reckoning, like, no, that's a rationalization that everyone's trying to cheat and we're just doing it better. I think the Patriots have wound up in that space a couple times. Mm-hmm. I do, and I think it's a reflection of a culture where of attention to.
So I don't mean interrupting, but I don't think the New England Patriots are sitting there about feeling guilty about cheating or anything like that. Deflategate wasn't bad. Spygate wasn't bad either. Now, if there were, I think, another form of cheating that was more direct than maybe I would say, but the way that I guess the Patriots got caught doing whatever they were doing, that's not a strong cheating necessarily. Like he said, they bent the rules, but it wasn't the hardcore cheating that would keep you up in the middle of the night in 20 years that you know you're not really a champion because you did hardcore cheating and that's the only reason why you won. I don't think the New England Patriots aren't there yet. They're not there with anything that they've done to keep them late at night thinking about how bad they've cheated. So let's continue.
Detail and looking for an advantage at every single opportunity. And that's that can.